Within the next few weeks, the enormous launch in Girder, which has been constructing the Colne Valley Viaduct, will be completing its 3.2-kilometre, 2-mile journey between the M25 and Hillingdon. It'll be somewhat of a bittersweet moment for me, as my coverage of Dominique's progress almost 2 years ago to the day was what really kick-started this channel. But it will be good to see the completion of the viaduct, which, in my opinion, looks graceful, despite its sheer size. It really has been a joy to follow its construction, and I'm always awestruck when I see it for myself. I imagine there will be an announcement about the completion of the viaduct very soon, although I haven't heard anything from HS2 Limited yet. But during my visit in July this year, the launching girder looked like it was very close to reaching its final destination. During my visit, I managed to get some drone footage with prior approval, as it falls within a flight restriction zone, or FRZ. I also walked along the Grand Union Canal to see where the viaduct crosses the canal. It really is an impressive sight as you walk along the canal towards the viaduct, which clears the navigation with a single, graceful 80-metre long span. Dominique had in fact crossed the canal in March this year, and since then has made steady progress across the southernmost lake, which is before the Chiltern mainline. The last of the 56 piers was also completed in March. The V-shaped piers in particular are an engineering marvel on their own, and each weigh up to 370 tonnes. They were constructed in situ using specially designed moulds into which concrete was poured. The launching girder is now on dry land and is progressing towards Harville Road. The viaduct will actually end just to the west of Harville Road. From there, it will pass under the road before heading immediately into a green tunnel known as Copville Tunnel. The transition from viaduct to tunnel also marks the boundary between the two different joint ventures, which are constructing HS2 in the south, with the SCS joint venture responsible for the route from Copville Tunnel towards central London, whilst the Align JV is responsible for constructing the route heading north, including the viaduct and Chiltern Tunnel. Align JV also operated the huge factory, which was used to manufacture the 1,000 precast concrete segments that weighed between 60 and 140 tonnes each, with the factory able to produce around 12 segments a week. As assembly of the viaduct is drawing to a close, the last of the concrete segments has already been manufactured. The manufacturing equipment will, however, remain in place until the last segment is lowered into place. After that, it is not yet known what the building will be used for. But ultimately, the site, which is where the spoil from the Chiltern tunnels was placed, will form part of a new chalk grassland and woodland. I made a video about this last year, which is worth watching if you haven't already. Now the viaduct is largely complete, you can really see the gentle curve of the bridge, which was made possible using a process known as match casting, which involves pouring the concrete for the segments next to the previously poured and cured segment. So when they are installed by the launching girder, they fit together perfectly. The segments were delivered to Dominique using a self-propelled modular transporter, otherwise known as an SPMT, and were mostly transported across the previously completed section of the viaduct. However, to construct the section which crosses Moorhall Road, the segments were transported via the temporary haul road that was constructed alongside the viaduct. The haul road was built largely on dry land, but there are also sections of pontoon bridge which will be disassembled once construction of the viaduct is complete. Construction of the viaduct won't end with the laying of the final segment, as there are concrete parapets which still need to be installed. These will add to the distinctive look and will help to reduce noise of the trains as they pass over the viaduct. And obviously, the overhead line equipment and tracks still need to be installed eventually. Despite the viaduct being 10 metres high, I do not feel that it dominates the landscape. Looking at a completed section last year over the northernmost lake, I believe the design had the desired effect of appearing to skip across the water. I'm certain though that it will divide opinion, with those who would prefer that it hadn't been constructed at all, whilst others may feel it should have been built more cheaply with perhaps a less elegant design. But I think the Colne Valley Viaduct goes to show the great deal of thought that has been put into the design of the HS2 structures, which will have a lasting impact on their surroundings. And with the Colne Valley in particular, it wouldn't have been right to use a less elegant design, even if it would have been cheaper. Now that the viaduct is almost complete, I know people will wonder what will happen to Dominique. Unfortunately, I think once this viaduct is complete, it won't be used in the UK again. There are certainly no projects that I'm aware of that will come close to the scale of this viaduct. And with HS2 curtailed, there is certainly no more use for it beyond Con on the HS2 route. Whatever your opinions are about HS2, I think most people would agree that it will be to the UK's detriment if we once again lose the valuable skills and knowledge gained during the construction of the line and the associated structures, which could be the case if the engineers and workers have no other significant projects to go on to within the UK. And with work on the larger civils now passing its peak, this worryingly may be the case. Which seems a bit of a sad way to end a video about a project I've been following so closely, and coverage of which was a pivotal moment for the channel. But fear not, I will be continuing to follow the construction of HS2 over the coming years and hope to grow and improve the channel. If you have any constructive suggestions about how the channel could be improved, please let me know in the comments or through social media. Alternatively, Patreon and YouTube supporters can reach me on my Discord and help to shape the future of the channel. And just before I sign off, I'd like to thank those Patreon and YouTube members for your continued support. It really is appreciated.